历了一年多的争论后，本周二，加州大学伯克利分校法学院院长发布公开信，代表法学院接受了一项建议，将沿用近一个世纪的法学院院名进行更名。在上世纪初期，旧金山律师 John Henry Bolt 的遗孀以其丈夫的名义向加州大学伯克利分校奉上了一笔慷慨捐赠。在此之后的近一个世纪以来，加州大学伯克利法学院被称作 Bolt Law School， 其所在的教学楼也被命名为 Bolt Hall。 不过 Bolt 本人不仅不是伯克利校友，同时他还是一名有据可考的种族主义者，也是排华法案的主要推动人。一年前，一名在加州大学伯克利分校法学院执教的律师撰文指出这一问题，并呼吁法学院更名。关于加州大学伯克利分校法学院名称的去留问题变成了争议性话题。
Two years ago, I was doing research in one of the campus libraries, and I chanced upon an anti-Chinese pamphlet written by someone named John Bolt. And working at the law school and having lived in Berkeley for a long time, I was curious, could this be the same John Bolt after whom the Berkeley Law School is named?And it took me only a few minutes of research to conclude that it was. The pamphlet was written in 1877, and it advocated eliminating Chinese immigration into the United States altogether, saying that Chinese immigrants brought all kinds of vices from China to the United States, that they were different, that they could never be assimilated, and that Chinese people could never be assimilated within the United States.Teaching at the law school, where so many of my students are of Chinese ethnic background, indeed a good number of them are from China itself, this kind of bothered me that I was going into a building that said Bolt Hall on it. So after a couple of years, I decided to research John Bolt and his history, and I wrote an op-ed that was published in the San Francisco Chronicle, as well as a law review article, and this generated a controversy within the law school.And a few months after those articles appeared in May of 2017, the dean of the law school, Erwin Chemerinsky, appointed a committee to look into the use of the Bolt name at the law school. That committee was in session for approximately a year, solicited a lot of input from students and alumni, other stakeholders in the law school.And made a recommendation in September of this year that the law school should cease to use the Bolt name on the classroom building, principally, where it's quite prominent, and also for the many different student groups and alumni organizations that use it. Dean Chemerinsky solicited more comment from September until yesterday, November 13th, and he issued his ruling.And he accepts the committee's findings and has recommended that the Bolt name no longer be on the main classroom building at Berkeley Law. This recommendation will go from the dean to the chancellor of the campus, Chancellor Crist, and she is charged with deciding whether to follow the law school's recommendation of eliminating the name.
I support the renaming or the denaming of Bolt Hall as Bolt Hall. I think there is something to be said about the history of, you know, the low Asian minority student population here and, you know, Bolt's previous support of the Chinese Exclusion Act. And I think these things have to be taken into account when...you know, when they're brought up as concerns by the minority group that such problems are affecting.
I mean, I think it's a good move to desegregate ourselves from racial discussion and racial discrimination. So I think it's a step in the right direction.
I support the renaming of the school. I think being associated with... negative racial things is bad.
虽然更名决定获得了法学院院长和多数学生的支持，但是类似的历史遗留问题依然是争议性话题。
Many people object to this kind of renaming on the grounds that people think that there is no stopping point for it, that it's a kind of slippery slope and it will keep going Indeed, President Trump said last year in August of 2017, where does it stop? Next, they'll be wanting to take off Jefferson's name. Next, they'll be wanting to take George Washington's name off. I think that that is simplistic, and that really what one needs to do is weigh the totality of circumstances in each case. I think for Berkeley Law, it was relatively easier than a lot of these renaming controversies, and there have been a good many in the United States in the last 5 years or so at campuses like Stanford and Yale and Harvard and others. These issues have arisen. And I think what an institution needs to do is weigh the totality of the historical figure's career, try to determine what his dominant legacy is, his most important contribution, and then look at the harm that was caused by the thoughts that are racist or otherwise objectionable, and make a decision based on the full record for each person. In the case of Berkeley Law, I think this was relatively uncomplicated, because John Bolt was not really known for much in his lifetime. This is not to say that he wasn't an accomplished lawyer. He was. But this is not a statesman like Thomas Jefferson or the father of a country like George Washington. This is a man whom in the year of his death was known, if he was known for much of anything at all, for his agitation against the Chinese. His attempts to exclude the Chinese from the United States was his most important accomplishment, according to biography that was written in 1901, the year that he died.